Hello, hello.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
Hello,
Hello,
hello.
teacher.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, hello. Good evening. Good evening,
Good evening.
everyone. Perfect.
Hi.
Hello, hello. Nice to see you, everyone. How are you doing? Everything
Hello.
okay? Or so-so?
So.
Oh my goodness, no, you have to say excellent. You have to say excellent, teacher. What about your weekend? Was it a good weekend? Not so much or bad? ¿Qué tal su fin de? Good one?
Good Monday, teacher.
Excellent.
It's Monday.
I know Mondays are difficult. I understand. Sometimes Mondays are difficult. But I
Yes.
appreciate. You hate Mondays. I know Mondays are difficult and I understand. But the good part is that you are here and I appreciate your punctuality to be here in the video conference. That is really nice of you. We're going back, or no, we're not going back. We are going ahead to the last class, the last classes for this course. So I want to first congratulate you for the effort that you do every day to continue working and learning in this course, and I appreciate that really much. Also, I want to congratulate people because I was checking on the platform and I was able to some of you, almost the majority of you, already finished with the information for unit number homework number 5, and also information about the final test. So I want to congratulate you for that information, and that is really nice. I have just a few people, let's see, like 3 or 4 people that are still working, and I need your collaboration to work on that one, right? And for that one, I will switch to Spanish on just for a little bit. Quiero felicitarles. Puedo ver, bueno, primeramente, buenas noches y bienvenidos a todos. Ya se los había mencionado. Quisiera felicitar a la mayoría de alumnos que están en el curso. He podido revisar su plataforma y he podido ver el progreso que ustedes han tenido. Y pues yo creo que la mayoría, quizás como un 90-95% de ustedes ya ha avanzado e incluso algunos ya han terminado la plataforma, ¿verdad? Todos los contenidos y eso es muy bueno. Les felicito. Gracias por tomar en cuenta mi recomendación de el fin de semana tratar de avanzar y si era posible terminar. Veo que ya muchos pudieron hacerlo. Esto, contrastado la información de la semana pasada, sí puedo ver que ya han avanzado mucho y eso es muy bueno. Felicitarles, me agrada entrar a la plataforma y ver que todos tienen, que todos tienen 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, 100. Eso es muy bueno, recordando que completar la plataforma es parte de los requisitos de este curso. Sorry. Y por ahí igualmente tengo quizás unas 3 personas, 3, 4 personas que todavía van un poquito atrasadas. Tengo una persona que va en la unidad, en la tarea 3. Tengo una persona que solo ha hecho la tarea 1 y eso es muy, muy, muy preocupante. Muy, muy preocupante. Así que pedirle la colaboración para poder completar la plataforma. Igual si ha tenido algún problema técnico, puede contactarse con mis compañeros para que ellos le den asistencia y le puedan ayudar. Si es que ha sido de carácter técnico por el cual usted no ha podido ingresar a la plataforma. Creo que después de la clase me comunicaré con algunos de ustedes para darles, pedirles su ayuda para que puedan completar la información. Así que por ahí me contactaré con algunos de ustedes y la mayoría, pues felicitarles. Veo que unos ya van en la tarea 4. Así que pedirles, ¿verdad?, que nos propongamos, si es posible, ya mañana o a más tardar miércoles, que esa plataforma esté completa, ¿verdad? Eso es una de las peticiones. Igual mis compañeras se comunican con ustedes y es parte del 80%, el cual debemos completar para, como requisito de inscripción del siguiente curso. Así que pongámonos las pilas. Yo sé que todos tenemos la capacidad y lo podemos hacer, así que les animo a que podamos estar ahí progresando y aprendiendo al mismo tiempo, que es la idea de la plataforma, aparte de ser un requisito que nos sirva de herramienta para medir nuestro conocimiento. Now, at this moment, let me switch to Spanish one more time, and I will check on the attendance. So, when you listen to your name, remember, you know what to do. Make a verbal confirmation that you are part of the media conference. Let me get started at this moment. Carlos Luis Cervano. Carlos Luis Cervano. Probably not at this moment. Carlos Roberto Nerio.
Presente.
Thank you. Ever Alex.
Present, teacher.
Much. I need your collaboration, please, with the microphone. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Francisco Isaac Sanchez. Please, please, I need your collaboration with the microphone. Necesito subir con el micrófono. Por ahí escucho una mascotita que no me va a dejar escuchar a los demás. Así que porfas, porfas, micrófono. All right, perfect. Thank you so much. I continue. Gabriel Esther Ponce.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Georgina Ivania Guzmán. Georgina Ivania Guzmán, right, I continue. Zeneida Esterle González. Zeneida Esterle González, all right, I continue. Guadalupe Lizeth Soriano. Miss Guadalupe Lizeth Soriano. All right, I continue. Yvonne Emelina Avilés.
Present.
Thank you. Jacqueline Natalie Carrillo. Jacqueline Natalie Carrillo. All right, continue. Jose Luis Gómez Guevara.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jose Moisés Paz Chavarría.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jose Roberto Ruiz Duarte. Jose Roberto Ruiz Duarte. Not present. José Roberto Vázquez.
Present.
Thank you. Juan Francisco González.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Julio César, not present. Karina Ivonne Linares.
Present.
Carla Mercedes Hernández.
Present.
Thank you. Lisette Esmeralda Tobar.
Present.
Thank you. Lucila Patricia Quinteros.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Madeline Lisette Montalbán.
Present.
Thank you. Margarita Lisette Medina.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Marvin Alberto Calderón.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Milagro de Los Ángeles Pérez Bautista.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ricardo de Jesús Ramírez.
Good evening, teacher.
Hello, hello. Roxana Patricia López.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Sara Analda Guzmán.
Present, teacher.
Xenia Patricia Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Yancy Maria Jacobo. I guess she's not available. And Yesenia Elizabeth Morales.
Present.
All right, thank you so much. Thank you so much for your presence. All right, just the final comment before we start on the today's practice. Remember, we're going final week, and it is essential to check on or to be present for all the rest of the week. That is very important to accumulate and to have access to the final minutes of the course, right? So I encourage you to be here and to log in to get all the minutes available, right? El último comentario antes de pasar ya con la práctica, pedirle siempre su colaboración como usted lo ha venido haciendo de estar conectado en las clases, recordando que esta ya es nuestra última semana, ¿verdad? Aparte de esta clase nos quedan 3 sesiones nada más y lo importante de los minutos de conexión. Para algunas personas pudiera ser que el ausentarse un día en esta última semana o perder ciertos minutos signifique no llegar al 80% y no vaya a ser que por eso usted pierda el beneficio de estar en los cursos. Así que le animo a estar acá presente y estar desde el inicio de la sesión, ¿verdad? Y no perderse ningún día de las clases que tenemos restantes para no encontrarnos en esa situación y que no vaya a ser algún problema para poder hacer la inscripción efectiva en el siguiente curso. Así que animarles, echémosle ganas. Ya hicimos el esfuerzo 3 semanas, nos quedan solo una, démosle. We can do it. We can do it. Let me see on this one. Let me show you some information that is for today. And we get started. Remember, we are going to be talking about really useful information. Let me see on this. All right, here we are. Session number 13, we're working in this content is based on homework number 5, and that is the topic, what are you doing? That is the information about. At this moment, we're going to be working with some vocabulary and to express some ideas. Take a look at this one. For example, I have an illustration for you. And in the illustration, you can see a person and the person is doing an action, right? The person is doing an action. So at this moment, I ask you the question and I need some volunteers to answer. Tell me, what is she doing? Volunteers?
Reading.
All right, but she's the complete reading. Sentence? Ah,
she's
thank
reading.
You. She's reading, okay. Reading. Perfect, perfect. She's reading, thank you so much. Take a look at the next one. All right, I have the sentence over there. She is reading. In this one, we can be very specific and we can say she's reading a book, right? To give more details about the action that she's doing. She's reading a book. Take a look at the next one. What is he doing? What is he doing?
He's riding a bike.
Riding a bike.
Thank you so much. Perfect, perfect. Thank you so much. He is riding a bike. Perfect, perfect. That's fine. He is riding a bike. Take a look at the next one. I have other information. And tell me, what is she doing?
She is working.
Uh-huh, she's working. What else can we say?
Office.
She's working in the office.
She's very typing.
Complete. She's typing. Uh-huh.
She's typing.
Huh? Any other sentence or any other idea that we can mention?
She's working.
She's working. Thank you. That's fine. Correct. Correct options. Actually, I have. Yes, tell me.
I can say she is writing in your computer.
Right. The best, in this case, probably texting is more for the cell phone, right? Because for okay. Text messages. So the context is better for the cell phone, texting. The okay. Other writing, it is considered, I don't have a pen, but when you say writing is more with a pen, right?
Okay.
When you are using something technological, like a keyboard, como un teclado, it's better to say typing. So the best option
typing.
In this context is okay. Typing, right? Typing. using a keyboard to write some. All right. I have the three sentences you mentioned. For example, I can say she's using the computer. That is in general, right? She is using the computer. Take a look at the other. She's typing, and I can create or complement, right? She's typing information. What else can you type? Other documents, or what other things can you type? Yo le puse el complemento que ella está digitando, es typing information. ¿Qué otro complemento pudiéramos utilizar con type? She is typing.
A letter.
A letter, thank you. Ajá. Can you say one more time, Mr. Isaac?
Es en Spanish, un ensayo.
An essay. Ajá.
Is
it possible? More info.
She's typing email.
She's typing an email. Thank you so much. That's correct. That is a possibility. She's typing an email. All right. You see, in this one, it is possible to have different complements, because in general, you can say she's typing, and that is the correct action. But you can include different complements. For example, she's typing information, she's typing a letter, she's typing a document, she's typing an essay. All the options that you mentioned are correct, and they are possible, possible answers to this. Take a look at the next one. And I say, she is working, all right? And in this one, we can include a complement of place. She is working in the office. What is other possible complement? Any volunteer? Other complement for the sentence?
She is working in your house.
All right, thank you. But the best option in that one, Mr. Jose Moises, should be she is working in her, right? The house, her house, right? Exactly.
Okay.
Just double check on that one. The idea was fine. Ahí nada más chequeando el uso de los posesivos, ¿verdad? Porque ahí sí me dice, she is working in your home, es como que ella está trabajando en mi casa, ¿verdad? Y entonces ahí, híjole, nos metemos en problemas, ¿verdad? No vaya a ser que me regañen a mí.
Okay.
I see. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So you double check on that one. She is working in her home. Excellent, right? Doing home office. Thank you. Just tell me.
At home?
At home, that is other possibility. She's working at home. Yes? Yes, yes, yes. My pleasure. Check on this one. These are probably, or the previous examples are probably very common. I have two expressions that I want to test how well we work on vocabulary. We have the information. What are they doing? Sorry. We have the info already.
They are sleeping.
Exactly. They are sleeping. Let me double check on this one, on the other sentences. All right. They are sleeping. Thank you so much. Take a look at this one. What is he doing?
He is walking the dog.
He is walking with your dog.
Mm-hmm.
He's taking a walk.
Taking a walk is possible. He is taking a walk is a possibility. And if we want to be more specific, as you mentioned, we can say he's walking the dog, right? That is the idea. He is walking the dog. And indeed, in that one, we are mentioning that he is taking the dog to walk outside, right? But the two possibilities are okay. Se me mencionaron, he is walking, ¿verdad? Eso es una acción que él está haciendo, ¿verdad? Él está caminando. But in this case, when you mention he is walking the dog, ya el contexto cambia un poquitito. Es como sacar a pasear el perro, ¿verdad? Entonces ahí la persona lo está mencionando, o lo podríamos mencionar de esa forma. He is walking the dog. Está paseando al perro. Take a look at the next one. What is he doing, people? But in English, in Spanish, I know it's easy. Tell me, Jose Luis.
He's shaving.
Uh-huh. Thank you. Thank you, Jose Luis. Thank you. Thank you so much. Excellent. That is probably vocabulary for boys. Thank you. That's fine. He's shaving his beard. If we want to be more specific, right? He's shaving. That is the action that you do to remove the hair, right? To remove the hair from your face. That is shaving, or from any part of the body, right? Ese es el verbo afeitarse. Para cualquier tipo de vello que usted se quiera eliminar de su cuerpo, lo utilizamos, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, las chicas, they shave the legs, ¿verdad? Generalmente, o algunas, optan por depilar, no depilar, sino que rasurar las piernas como una alternativa. Pero ahí cada quien, right? You can shave, in this case, any part of the body, and in this one, he's shaving his beard. Now, take a look at the next one, and that is probably the challenge. And let's see how well we do it. Let me see. Take a look at the other illustration, people. Tell me, what is she doing? And does anybody know what she's doing?
She's cutting her eyebrow.
All right, cutting her eyebrow. It could be a possibility. It could be a possibility. But there is probably other more specific expression for this one. Does anybody know it?
Painting.
Painting, it might be, but in this one it's more like removing, I guess, right? Like removing on that one. Ladies, this is something that probably the majority of ladies do, right? Esto es algo que es la mayoría.
She's painting.
She's painting? All right, thank you so much. It could be a valid answer. Thank you so much. All right. Thank you so much. Probably. All right. I will use this picture for other contexts, right? Probably she's painting, and you are correct. Probably she's painting the eyebrows, but there is other possibility that we can mention to remove the hair, right? Para remover el vello, que sería como depilarse, podríamos utilizarlo. Y creo que ella se está pintando y es posible. She's painting. Or probably you can say she's making up, ¿verdad? Se está maquillando. She's making up the eyebrows. In this one, I have
feeling.
Probably. In this one, probably we can say she's plucking her eyebrows. That is the specific action to remove the hair. Esa sería como la expresión o el verbo de remover el pelo, así como depilado, ¿verdad? Con un movimiento y arrancadito, right? She's plucking her eyebrow. We can mention that information. Something that is probably common for many people, right? And that is the important part when we talk about different actions. Okay, right? Now, let's see on this one. Let's work on an exercise at this moment. All right. People, do you know what mimicking is? Check the illustration. What is mimicking? What is it?
No.
Does anybody know?
Touch in the mirror.
Touching the person is touching the mirror, right? That is the mime. That is a person.
Yes,
mime.
Thank you. At this moment, we do something similar. What do we do? Because we're using the camera, and I need the help of everybody at this one. We are going to do an action. We do an action, and we check on your classmates, right? and we are going to try to give a description. For example, if I do a mimic like this one, take a look at my camera probably, right? And imagine this one, and I begin like that one, right? What am I doing? What do you think?
Listen to music.
You are listening to music, an action in progress, right? Imagine that I do something like this. What am I doing?
Dancing.
You are dancing.
Excellent. Thank you so much. You mentioned you are dancing. At this moment, what we do is something similar, and I need everybody's collaboration with the camera, all right? So we're going to be mimicking. Necesito su colaboración porque vamos a hacer una actividad. En lugar de hablarlo inicialmente, vamos a hacer una mímica de una acción. Okay, similar como yo estaba por ahí, listening to music. I was just trying dancing, right? Usted piensa en una acción y trate de hacerla en este momento. Yo le voy a decir cuándo, ¿verdad? Pero lo vamos a hacer todos simultáneamente, así no vamos a ir tomando turnos. Va a decir, ahora vos, dale, dale. No. We go everybody at the same time. Vamos a hacerlo todos al mismo tiempo. Usted escoja cuál actividad va a ser. No va a ser la misma para todos, ¿verdad? No es copiarle a alguien más. Imagínese algo sencillito que pueda hacer y lo mostramos en cámara. Right, we're going to have approximately 15 seconds. Right, 15 seconds to do the action. Vamos a tener aproximadamente unos 15 segundos en los cuales nosotros vamos a estar haciendo repetidamente esa mímica. Así algo facilito, algo rapidito. You are going to take a look at the cameras of your classmates and later we are going to report. Vamos, aparte de estar haciendo la mímica, les pido de favor, veamos la cámara de sus compañeros igualmente, porque después vamos a crear un reporte oral. Vamos a decir, por ejemplo, Gonzalo, right? Gonzalo is. Vamos a hacer con el presente, right? Gonzalo is, y vamos a utilizar el ing, right? That is the objective at this moment. Are you ready, people? Yes or no?
Yes.
Perfect. Yes. Excellent. Okay. Thank you so much. Perfect. When I count to three, we begin doing the action. ¿Verdad? Cuando cuente tres, comenzamos a hacer la acción. No speaking, right? No hablamos. Y tampoco me decir, tal persona está haciendo tal cosa. Eso lo hacemos como clase al final. All right? Let's get ready. 3, 2, 1. Begin with the action, please. Begin with the action. Everybody, the action. Thank you. Take a look at the camera from your classmate. Thank you. Something simple. Perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Perfect. 10 more seconds. 10 segundos más. Take a look at the camera. Thank you, everybody. Excellent. Thank you. 5 more seconds. Perfect. 3, 2, 1. Done. Thank you so much. Thank you for your collaboration, people. Thank you so much. Now, woof, everybody's tired at this moment. Woof, doing activities at this moment. Hasta le dio calor de estar haciendo la actividad. All right? Para que vean que aunque estamos en línea, ya ve que siempre nos movemos, no solo nos vamos a quedar sentaditos, ya ve, se nos presta la actividad. Perfect. Now, people, let's begin. What? Let's see. Lo vamos a hacer en forma de presente para seguir con la práctica, ¿verdad? Yo sé que la persona ya no está haciendo la actividad, pero usted como se recuerda, yo le voy a preguntar, what is, le digo la persona y le digo doing, ¿verdad? Y usted me reporta en presente tal cual, solo por cuestión de práctica. Tell me, what is Francisco doing? Si vieron a Francisco, what is Francisco doing? ¿Alguien que lo haya visto? ¿Que lo haya logrado ver en la camarita? What is Francisco doing? People? Nobody. All right. I choose other person. Voy a coger otra persona. Tal vez alguien logró ver la cámara de ese compañero. Let's see. What is José Luis Gómez doing? Nothing. All right. I switch on the question. Vamos a darle otro
enfoque. It's a taken picture.
Ajá. Tell me. Ajá.
José Luis Gómez is taking pictures.
He's taking pictures. Is that okay, José?
Correct.
Excellent. Yes. Thank you. I check José with the cell phone with the flashlight. The flash, right? Ah, perfect. Sorry. He's taking pictures. Thank you. José Luis, do you remember all their activity from your classmate? And you make the report. Sin necesidad de la pregunta, el que usted haya visto, forme la oración. Y le mencionamos el nombre y la actividad que estaba haciendo. O que está haciendo, suponiendo que la está haciendo en este momento.
Teacher, I can't see anybody.
Nobody. My goodness. Probably for the setting of the camera, right?
Yes.
Probably for the setting. Tal vez por la configuración de la visualización. But no problem, no problem. Let me ask you and people. What about any other person that remembers? ¿Quién sí logró ver a alguien de sus compañeros que nos pueda colaborar con el reporte?
Yo, bro, teacher.
Thank you, Roxana. Tell me.
Yo también.
Okay, sí.
Ever, a Ever B y a Ricardo, me parece que se llama.
Okay, perfect.
Ever is speaking by phone.
Ah, excellent. Speaking by phone, right? Is that correct, Ever?
Y a Ricardo.
Yes, teacher.
He's cutting his hair.
Okay, Ricardo is cutting his hair. Is that okay, Ricardo? Excellent. Thank you. You see, cutting the hair. Thank you so much, Roxana. Good report. Good report. I go at this moment with Francisco and then with Madeline. Francisco, tell me, what do you remember? What is your classmate doing?
No me equivoco. Patricia López is reading a book.
Ah, Patricia López is reading a book. Was that okay?
Esther. Smoking. Is smoking.
Esther?
Esther Ponce. Is smoking.
Really? Is smoking, yes. Esther? Yes. Excellent. Thank
yes.
you. Okay, good action. Good action and good report. Perfect. Perfect, perfect. I appreciate on that one. Miss Madeline, do you have any other report? All right, no problem. I continue. Does anybody else have the chance to check on your classmates' action? ¿Será que alguien más pudo ver lo que sus compañeros estaban realizando y así reportamos más información? Probably not at this moment. Let me see. Let me work on this one. All right. I checked on some people. They were doing some actions. Because of that, then I will try to do them, right? Por cuestiones de cámara de configuración, yo creo que no tuvimos la chance de ver a la mayoría. Pero yo les voy a hacer las mímicas de lo que ellos estaban haciendo, ¿verdad? Ahí si me ven bailar, ahí me disculpan. So don't worry about it. And this one. Tell me. What is this person doing? This was Juan Francisco. Yo voy a hacer lo que estaba haciendo Juan Francisco, right? And you report the sentence. Juan Francisco is. Yo voy a hacer el espejo de Juan Francisco haciendo la acción y usted me reporta. Juan Francisco is in the action, all right? Juan Francisco, it is one.
He's brushing. Juan Francisco.
Like brushing the teeth.
All right. Juan Francisco is brushing. His teeth, right? Remember on the, yes. Remember on the correct possessive adjective, right? Remember on the correct possessive adjective.
Yes.
Excellent. Yes. So much. Because imagine
teacher,
if you tell
I can
me.
See a,
see?
I can see a Margarita. Yo vi a Margarita.
Ah, okay. Tell me about Margarita. Tell me.
She is drinking.
Margarita is drinking. Yeah. Excellent. And tell me, what are you drinking?
Vodka.
Water. water. No. Water. Come on. I'm sorry.
Coffee
and tea. I know. I'm just kidding.
Water.
If I la pronunciación, lo siento. I'm sorry. Sorry, my bad pronunciation.
It's Monday.
Yeah, it's Monday. Exactly. Probably on Thursday. Probably, right? Thursday or Friday. Those are good days.
No,
never. Thank you, Margarita. That's fine. Only water and coffee and tea. That's okay. Thank you. All right. Let's see. I remember other people. For example, Georgina was doing an action, and I will do it for you. Georgina was doing like this.
Georgina is pumping.
And pumping what?
Air.
All right. Hair. Exactly. Thank you. Perfect. Remember to be alert of the possessive adjectives. Nada más el anuncio y el comercial de estar pendiente de los adjetivos posesivos. Imagínense que en anterior, ¿verdad? El ejemplo que estamos haciendo de Juan Francisco. Y me dice usted, Juan Francisco, is brushing your teeth? ¿Cómo que Juan Francisco me está cepillando los dientes a mí? Vaya? You say, what? Ah, take a look at that one. Tengan cuidado con los adjetivos posesivos, son engañosos, ¿verdad? Ajá. Take a look at that one, right? For example, if you say, the example, right? Georgina is combing your hair. No, Georgina is combing her hair. Talking about, because it's the hair of her. Her, right? Ahí igualmente, ¿verdad? El adjetivo posesivo adecuado a la persona, ¿verdad? Si no, me diría como que ella me está peinando a mí, ¿verdad? Y ella, por el momento, no me ha dicho, teacher, le voy a dar una peinadita. Not at this moment, right? She's not offered the help. Todavía no me ha querido ayudar con mi estilo, right? Thank you so much, right? You see on that one. Perfect. Do you remember any other? ¿Se recuerdan de alguien más, de los que estuvo participando?
No, the teacher.
Ah, okay. Tell me what the teacher is.
Is swimming.
Exactly. Thank you. Right. I was going like that.
Swimming.
The teacher is swimming. Perfect. Perfect. Thank you so much. I appreciate on your collaboration. Now, let's do something. We continue with more practice. And at this moment, we're going to have a speaking practice. And we are going to imagine, right? Imagination. We imagine we are having an international conversation. And the conversation goes like this. Take a look at this one. Let me see. This is the information for the question. All right. I need your collaboration with the microphones, people. Please. Thank you. That's fine. That's perfect. We begin the conversation like this. We imagine we are having an international telephone conversation. The person begins like this, like, hello, sorry to call you at this time, right? The person begins like this, hello, sorry to call you at this time. The other person is going to report, hey, it's, and you mention the time. For example, it's 3 a.m., right? Or it's 4 a.m., or you can tell any time that you want, right? In that space, you mention a time. The next conversation is, the next participation is, I see, it's 5 p.m. for me. Tell me, what are you doing? The person say, all right, I am, and you report on many activities. And finally, you say, what about you? And the other person is going to report on the different activities that he or she is doing. I will explain to you the activity. Vamos a tratar de interpretar una mini conversación. Imagínense que alguien tiene un su conocido y le está hablando internacionalmente. Quiere decir eso que para él es una hora y para nosotros puede ser otra hora. Y lo vamos a iniciar de tal forma. Hello, sorry to call you at this time. ¿Verdad? La persona dice, hey, hola, siento llamarte a esta hora. Y usted le contesta, hey, y ahí le reporta una hora, como it's 1 a.m., hey, es la 1 de la mañana, por darle un ejemplo. En el primer espacio, para el participante B, completamos con una hora. La otra persona le responde, ay, sí, como, ah, ya veo, como me doy cuenta, ¿verdad? It's 5 p.m., por darles un ejemplo, ¿verdad? Son las 5 p.m. para mí, ¿verdad? La persona le reporta qué hora es en el lugar donde supuestamente está ubicada, ¿verdad? En ese momento, recuérdese, en llamadas internacionales. Y continúa, ¿verdad? Porque la persona aprovechando que le echó una socorita de saldo al teléfono, quiere averiguar, ¿verdad? Y le dice, hey, tell me, what are you doing? Dime, ¿qué estás haciendo? What are you doing? And the person says, ah, all right. Says, ah, bien, ni modo, ¿verdad? Ya me despertó, platiquemos con la persona. I am, and you report on the information. I am watching TV, I am drinking soda, I am texting my friends, I am playing video games, I am cleaning the house. You report as many activities as possible, right? And at the end you say, what about you? At the end, you ask information about what the other person is doing. And the other person also reports on personal, on actions in the moment. That is what we do, ¿verdad? Al final, como la persona le dice, y dime, ¿qué estás haciendo? Usted ni modo, ¿verdad? Como le comentaba, ya está en la conversación, y le dice, ah, está bien. Yo estoy, y comienza a dar el reporte de actividades de lo que usted está realizando. Si no está haciendo nada en el momento, imagíneselo, pretenda que usted está haciendo algo, ¿verdad? Ya tenemos cierto vocabulario, lo utilizamos para reportar las actividades. And finally, you ask, what about you? Ahí al final usted le hace la misma pregunta a su compañero. Cuando utilizamos la expresión, what about you, hace referencia a una pregunta que se hizo con anterioridad. Y eso hace referencia a what are you doing, ¿verdad? En lugar de repetir otra vez, and you, what are you doing? Solo le podemos decir, what about you? Diciendo, ¿y usted o vos qué estás haciendo? And the person is going to report, ¿verdad? Y la persona de ahí, a partir de eso, va a reportar también acciones que él esté haciendo en este momento. And we create on the conversation. I will be monitoring you and checking how you work. All right? Is there any question about this activity and what we do? Questions for this part? Any question, people?
No.
Right. Thank you so much. No. All right. Thank you so much. Let me share a picture if possible. Let me work on this one. All right. I will send you the file. Let me see. Let me check on this one. Déjeme por aquí buscarle rapidito la imagen por si no ha tenido la chance de copiarla. Se la voy a compartir. All right, I will share it in the groups. Si puedo, se las mando por mensaje ahí cuando estemos en el breakout room. Así usted tiene más o menos la idea de la conversación, o si no, espero que ya haya agarrado más o menos la idea principal. We work at this moment in groups of, in pairs, right? There is going to be one trio. Vamos a trabajar en parejas, pero va a haber un grupo que va a ser de tres y ahí nos alternamos para poder practicar. At this moment, we begin working and let's do our best to report on activities. Thank you so much. Let's begin. Thank you.
teacher.
Hello, hello, mister.
Acá se ha ido la luz y estoy con datos.
All right. All right. I guess I assigned you to a group. Creo que lo asigné con un grupo, si es posible. Para participar, le agradecería por ahí que pueda participar, ¿verdad? Si no, pues hagamos el esfuerzo siempre de estar por acá conectados, ¿ok?
Sí, sí, está bien.
Perfecto. No sé si le cayó la notificación ahí para unirse a la sala.
Sí, ahorita.
Ok, perfecto. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you.
Tenés que decir y un verbo con ing.
Okay.
Yeah. Ajá. I am.
Okay. ¿Qué estoy haciendo, verdad?
Yes.
Entonces sería I am a student.
In this studying. One is studying. Studying.
Studying.
Ajá.
I am studying. Ajá.
Uh-huh.
Exactly, exactly. Ajá. Uh-huh. I am studying.
Okay.
Y yo pregunto, ¿verdad?
Sí, what about you?
What about you?
Uh-huh. Okay, I am paying in my check.
Uh-huh. Paying my check. Remember to give as many details as possible. Thank you. Recuérdense también, lo estamos haciendo muy bien. Nada más recordarles de incluso mencionar más ideas en ING si es posible, ¿verdad? Si no, tal vez podemos practicar un poco más el uso del progresivo. All right?
Thank okay.
you. Alternate okay. and continue okay. practicing, please. Thank you so much.
Okay. Hello, Francis.
Ahora yo le pregunto a Francisco.
Okay.
Ah, okay. Ajá, y después que él me... Okay.
Excellent.
Okay. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Tell me, what are you doing?
I am sleeping.
Uh-huh.
What about you?
I am working at the office. Okay, now you are A and I are I.
All right, continue working. Remember to alternate as you're going to, right? You alternate, one person is letter A, the other person is letter B. ¿Verdad? Así como lo están haciendo, pueden alternar una persona. Si ya terminamos el diálogo, cambiamos de
rol. It's raining.
I know.
In her house.
All right. I know. Rain sometimes complicates the connection. But my final comment is to try to incorporate as many activities as possible in the progressive. en la pregunta que tenemos por ahí, que what are you doing, tratamos de incluir la mayor cantidad de detalles, ¿verdad? Así tratamos de reportar muchas actividades, no nos quedamos solo con una, ¿verdad? Al que no tengan sentido, usted mencione bastantes actividades, ¿vale? La idea es practicar. What are you doing? I am watching TV, I am checking my cell phone, I am cleaning the house. Como que somos multitasking, ¿verdad? Multitareas por ahí. Así que les animo a seguir practicando. Thank you so much.
Thank you, teacher.
It's sleepy.
What about you?
I come back to work.
Okay.
¿Cómo sería ahí? Yo creo que ese es irregular, pa.
I am coming.
Ya le vamos a preguntar al teacher cuando se asome por ahí.
Hello, hello, I am here.
Hello.
You see, I come in the correct time. Ya ve, siempre vengo al momento preciso.
En el momento justo.
Ya ve, ajá, excelente.
Y la actividad de regresar de algún lugar. Yo estoy regresando. I come back, siempre, normal.
I am coming back in the ING. Uh-huh. I am coming back. Ahí está para mencionar que la acción de regresar, digamos que usted ya viene de camino, de vuelta a su casa. Y siempre lo conjugamos utilizando la combinación verbo to be más el verbo en ing. Usted puede decir, I am coming back to my house. Right? Ahí está como diciendo, estoy regresando a la casa. Right? In that case. Uh-huh. Or okay. The opposite, o en este caso, si usted se va movilizando, pero a un destino, por lo menos a su trabajo, usted puede decir, I am going to work, ¿verdad? Voy al trabajo, right? Y come back es regresar. Generalmente lo podemos utilizar como del punto inicial donde usted salió, ¿va? Llamémosle punto A, su casa, fue a un lugar y regresa otra vez a ese punto, que generalmente para nosotros es nuestro hogar. Ahí sí podríamos decir, come back. ¿Verdad? Ahí sí. Si usted va a visitar el parque, no podríamos decir I am coming back to the park. Tal vez en otro contexto es posible, pero en ese lo más adecuado sería I am going to the park. ¿Mm?
Okay.
Perfect.
Thank
perfect.
You, teacher. Thank
okay. You. Continue practice. I want to listen to you. Quiero escucharles in the conversation.
Okay, okay.
Thank you.
Comienza.
Pasemos ahí. Va, iniciamos ahí, Karina.
Okay. Hello, sorry to call at this time. No, ahí lo hice como en tono de pregunta, pero. Hello, sorry to call at this time.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, it's 5:00 p.m.
I see. It's 9 a.m. for me. Tell me, what are you doing?
I'm taking a shower. What about you?
I am working now.
No, you are not working, you are calling by phone. Ah, come. That's perfect. Es que tal vez trabaje de call center. PAM, ajá, 9 a.m., ajá, exactly.
Yeah, call center, sí.
In the call center. Tal vez le llama para ofrecerle algún producto o algo así. Ah, you see, excellent.
Exactly, in that
context. Perfect, thank you so much. Just double checking the sentence, Mr. Ricardo. I am taking, con el uso del verbo to be, creo que me le faltó, o si no, pues lo mencionamos tal cual, ¿verdad? I am taking, right? I am taking a shower, la expresión completa, right? Perfect. Continue, do it one more time. Tenemos alrededor de un minuto, pueden practicar una vez más. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.
Pero la practicamos bastante, ya nos vamos, Alu.
No, ya no vamos. I am here. What happened?
Teacher, es que no hay luz.
Energía en mi casa y ya no puedo ver la conversación.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
No, pero ya vino, ya vino.
Yay, excellent.
Ay, ya llegó.
Hoy sí la puedo ver.
Ay.
All right.
Vaya, Carlita, hoy sí.
Wow, hoy sí.
Perfect. I listen to you, people.
Ajá, vaya. No. Hello. Sorry to call at this time.
Hey, it's 7 o'clock.
I see. It's 5 p.m. for me. Tell me, what are you doing?
All right. I am eating breakfast right now. What about you?
I am studying in the office.
Okay.
Excellent. Thank you so much. You see? Perfect. Thank perfect. You. Okay, we return. Hoy sí nos vamos, right? Hoy we go to the meeting room. Excellent, excellent, right? Como esto siempre le dice que la grabación está en curso, piensa uno que ya va para afuera, but don't worry.
Eso pensamos.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, teacher. People. Yes, tell me.
Sí, en español, porque me sale más fácil.
Okay.
Si yo quiero poner, por ejemplo, que son las 6 de la tarde.
Uh-huh.
Si para mí son las 6 de la tarde con 6:20,
uh-huh,
¿cómo sería la forma correcta de ponerlo, de expresarlo?
It is 6:20 p.m.
It is.
It is 6:20 p.m.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Remember that the use of o'clock is only for a specific time. La palabra o'clock es solo cuando la hora es entera, va ni un minuto más ni un minuto menos. Una en punto, dos en punto.
Correcto. Y podría ser it's 20 past 6 at night.
Yeah, it could be possible. 20 past. Yeah, it's fine. Two different forms.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you. All right, people. At this moment, I am going to check on the attendance. I was checking on some of you. Estaba chequeando algunas salas por tiempo. No pude chequearles a todos, pero les agradezco que algunos tuvieron dificultades con energía eléctrica. Y ahí estuvimos haciendo el intento por conectarnos. Y eso es muy bueno. Les agradezco siempre el esfuerzo que hacemos por estar acá participando. Let's check on this one. Carlos Luis Cervano. It's not at this moment. Carlos Roberto Nerio.
Present.
Thank you. Ever Alexander Cabrera.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Francisco Isaac Sánchez.
Sorry, present.
Thank you. Gabriela Esther Ponce.
Present.
Thank you. Georgina Ivania Guzmán.
Present.
Thank you. Zenaida Sterling González. She's not available at this moment. Guadalupe Lizeth Soriano. Not at this moment. Yvonne Emelina Aviles.
Present.
Thank you. Jacqueline Natalie Carrillo. Jacqueline Natalie Carrillo. Right. I continue. Jose Luis Gomez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Jose Moises Paz Chavarria. I guess he has technical issues with the electricity. I continue. Jose Roberto Ruiz Duarte. Not available. Jose Roberto Vázquez.
I hear, teacher.
Thank you. Juan Francisco González.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Karina Ivonne Linares.
Present.
Thank you. Carla Mercedes Hernández.
Present.
Thank you. Lizette Esmeralda Tobar.
Present, teacher.
Lucila Patricia Quinteros.
Present.
Madeline Lizette Montalbán.
Present.
Thank you. Margarita Lizette Medina.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Marvin Alberto Calderón.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Milagro de Pérez.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo de Jesús Ramírez. Thank you.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Roxana Patricia López.
Present.
Thank you. Sara Guzmán. Zenia Patricia Hernández.
Present, teacher.
En Yesenia Elizabeth Morales.
Present, teacher.
Right. Thank you so much, people. I appreciate on your participation in the class. Don't forget about the platform. And let's see each other tomorrow. Have a good night, people. Take care.
Good night, teacher.
Night. Good night, teacher.
Good night, teacher. Good night, everybody.
Bye-bye.
See you tomorrow.
See you.